Hi, I'm Dr. Kodlady Surendra Shetty. I'm the spine surgeon practicing in Spine Care Hospital, West of Cord Road, Bangalore. Disc prolapse is like the outer cover of the disc getting tore and the inner soft disc coming out. This is called a herniation. So this is called herniated. So every disc prolapse is a herniated disc prolapse. So it can, when it herniates, it can put pressure on the spinal cord, or it can put pressure on the nerve roots. In the case of cervical spine or in the case of thoracic spine, when the disc herniates, it presses upon the cord. It can press. Suppose central disc prolapse is there, it presses upon the cord. When it presses upon the cord undergoes degeneration. It undergoes, there will be some sort of an edema, then this weakness below the, in the lower limbs and in the upper limbs. So when the disc prolapses on the sides where there are nerve roots, it may be on the right side or it may be on the left side, so then we will have a nerve root pain. Depending upon the site of the disc prolapse, patient will have different varied type of pain. For example, when he has a cervical spine in C5-6 disc prolapse, if it is pressing, herniating on the right side, then it presses upon the right nerve roots. The patient will have pain in the neck, upper scapular region, shoulder, arm and forearm and into the head. And suppose the disc prolapse is in the lower back, pressing upon L5 nerve roots, then patient will have lower back pain, buttock pain, pain along the posterior aspect of the thigh, pain along the calf muscles, and pain along the dorsum of the foot. So depending upon which nerve is affected, the patient will have symptoms.